Basically, it focuses on client and salesperson communication. If any client or a company wants to publish their business requirements, like if they want, like if a IT company requires any iOS developer, or any restaurants require some waiters or some chefs, then they can publish their business requirement through the application, and the salesperson will communicate to the business and satisfy the business requirement, and the data will be added in the application. All the business requirements will be fetched from the geolocation. Our current latitude longitude will be fetched of the salesperson nearby, in the nearby area, if we set for 5 kilometers by default, and you want, if we want to change the radius, we can. And according to the distance, you will be getting the restaurants or business companies which will have the business requirements. If the business requirements are not there, it will not show.
So the goal of the application is that to reduce the efforts of the salesman. If suppose a salesman has come to an IT company, but he doesn't have customers records of previous meetings, he doesn't know who is the owner of that IT company. So we are providing all that information in the application with him, so he can get all these details on the customer doorstep itself. Second point is that you can easily go to the customer, because we are providing a geolocation, that is, we are providing a directions within the app. So it can directly configure the directions, providing a minimized distance from there. Another is that it will help him to update all the data in a timely and accurate manner. That was an issue in previous systems. In related background, the system which was given in our SRS was Salesforce Automation. It was a desktop based system where the employee has to go to the office, he has to get that desktop on, and then he had to manually insert that data in the lab on the computer. But our proposition is on mobile, so he can update automatically and at the customer's doorstep within. That's the main advantage of our application.
So this will all revolve around the contacts that are stored.
Yes, yes. It's that how the customers and salesmen interact, and the app mainly focuses on a salesman to reduce the efforts and timing, so he can easily interact with them.
If any company has any requirements, like they publish their requirements on naukri.com and so on, so they can publish a requirement on our application, and salesperson will communicate with the employee or the head person to settle out the publishing and all the other meeting.
Suppose you are selling printers, right? Okay, then a company has a requirement of printers, then he will contact the backend person and their requirement will be published. So our office will allocate those requirements to the salesman, and each of the salesmen who is nearer to that office will go to that client, and he will discuss all the possibilities, and he will sign a contract, and once the meeting is done, he will fill out the form that these points were discussed in this meeting, and then it will be updated in the database. The focus was to update all those meetings which are done with the client.
But how you say that they can post the ad on naukri.com?
Yes,
on
yes.
How will they know your app? How do you publish it? How do they know your app? How do you publish it?
Business in the business, if any company wants to publish, he will use the admin side of the application. He will publish the requirements, and it will be displayed in the salesperson application. This is our application. So if any company has the requirement, it will be displayed in the home page only, by if it is within the radius the salesperson has set.
Sir, it is sort of just rel, that you call the just rel person, then you ask that I need a plumber for my, then he will send those requirement, and a salesman, it is similar, that salesman will get that requirement. It's like that. The tools and technologies which we have used is for creating Android application, we have used Android Studio. For we have used for server is a Django framework, which is a Python framework. It is an open source. And for database, we have used NoSQL, MongoDB database. And for editing our code, we have used Sublime Text Editor. Methodology was, first we initiated the how actually the what was the definition in our SRS. Then we designed few wireframes. After that, we started building on the backend side. Once the backend was complete, parallelly, the Android application was developed. And once the connection between those backend and server was done, we initiated to develop proper GUI, and after that we did few testing and then the application was run. And still it will be an adopting phase if any more changes if we need.
We have divided our project into three phases. So in our first phase, at the time of the definition we were given, we have first started with the selecting of tools and technologies which we will use for our project. And then we have designed some wireframes and some diagrams for use cases, sequence diagram, flowchart, and etc. These are the concepts which we have used in our project: Django for backend purpose, MongoDB for database, Python related language, Android for application, Google Maps API for getting the latitude longitude of the restaurant or company, and the REST API for backend communication, Android application, and Django server.
For this application, we have used Zomato's dataset because it already provides us with latitude and longitude, so it was easy for us to manage.
So dataset is already publicly available.
Yes, yeah. It was available on Kaggle, so we downloaded that dataset, and that because we needed the latitude and longitude to find the
actions. They were providing the latitude and longitude data, so it was easy for us to get the restaurant's latitude and longitude directly instead of just searching and collecting.
Manually collecting those data.
So before starting our app, we started with the wireframes. So the wireframes are required to know which activity we required in app, what are the main screens are there, what are the activity we need. So first of all, we started with the small registration screen. Then there are some login screen. After that, what are the screens we required, like that, what will be the data will be shown in this. So like after that, when we click the nearby restaurant, all that, after getting the latitude and longitude, we get the, all the restaurant details from that. After restaurant details, we click on that restaurant details and we get the, all the information regarding the restaurants. So these are the main concept of our in wireframe.
So this is the system.
One thing I'm trying to understand is like, I don't know whether it's part of your use case, I'm not sure. In a Salesforce application, why would a restaurant?
We were given an open ID, like we can select any business or any restaurant or any education purpose.
Yes, yeah. So we selected a restaurant.
We have selected restaurant.
Because the data set which was available was of restaurant. That's why for an example we used that.
So we chose the restaurant domain.
This can implemented with all the other industries as well. But this is just an example.
So you got the data set?
Yes.
By the restaurant, we completed our proof of concept for the SRA we were given. We can implement the same with the data, and we can switch to organization or any company or any other purpose also. So this is the flowchart. After the salesperson logins into the app, the current location will be automatically fetched by the Google API. It searches for the nearby business requirements. If the business requirements is available, the application displays the business requirements. Salesperson can select any of the business requirements he is interested in, and after that request for the meeting to the company or the restaurant. And if the meeting has happened, then the salesperson will generate a record, and after generating it will be stored in the database, and the company person can also see and the salesperson can also see that my meetings that I have completed this meeting, and after any time, after 1 year or 2 year or 5 years, you can see that I have completed the meeting on this day to this restaurant or the
you can record a text of the meeting.
Yes.
Yeah. And if the nearby location is not available, it will be not displaying. And if salesperson do not want to select any particular, if meeting has not done, confirm, it can select any other business requirements, so on, it will be carried out. So this is the use case. The use case which we were given in the SRS, it was only of the view record and
add record.
But we have implemented some other functionalities to our project. This is the sequence diagram.
Other functionalities were the map direction, which we told it was not given in our SRS, but we have implemented. Another is filter, which we are giving an option to the salesperson that if you want to select more distance, suppose by default it is 5 kilometers, but if you want to go more than 5 kilometers, you can go up to 10 kilometers. It depends on the salesman. So this way we have improved a little bit of our application as well.
Chicken diagram for the whole system.
In phase two, we started development of our application. On the backend side in Django, first we went with the PyMongo, which is a module through which we can connect the MongoDB. But it was like we were doing a layman's term. But Django provides a more better functionalities. Like it provides model view template architecture. So after that, we had to flush out whole our application, whole our server code. Then we come again, did all those functions in the model view template architecture. And once that was done, it was working perfectly. And we tested all these modest API modules in Postman as well. These are the Django models which I was talking about. It is like we are creating a table syntax that what will be in that table of which we are creating. As you know that MongoDB is a NoSQL, that is no table, but it has a dictionary type format. So we need this type of, it provides, that is the beauty of that Django, that it provides such type of, through which we can easily interact with functions. It has a serializer module which directly converts that NoSQL data into JSON and directly we can pass on to the application. So we have many functionalities which we have used in Django as well.
And the JSON data will be communicated to REST API.
This is a sample which we have shown.
Sir, here are the ID of the restaurant, restaurant name, owner, mobile number, city, address, which locality, and the latitude and longitude, which we require to find the directions, and what type of cuisines they are providing. This is just an example.
Haversine formula. For finding the direction, it was given in our SRS that Haversine formula should be used to find a direction from one geolocation to another geolocation. So we implemented that, and there is a function code which we have shown to. This is the function code which we have implemented. Here you give two latitude longitudes and it will automatically calculate the distance and we provide to the app form module.
So you're not using any of the Google APIs?
No, sir. It's used for the direction. Google Maps
for
are used direction, for the direction.
We have used Google Maps API, but for the calculating of the distance, we were asked to use the Haversine formula in our SRS.
As I told you, sir, that by default it is 5 kilometers. So within the 5 kilometers, those restaurants who have business opportunities, that are only shown. For that, we have used the Haversine formula. And this is the sample which distance, how our distance is. These are distances in kilometers.
So after that we started to integrated the Django framework with application. So after, what are the process we required? So first we integrated the app with Django. The first we required the location from the phone. After getting the location, we get the latitude longitude from the getting the phone. After getting the latitude longitude, we get as the wireframe we have created, then we show the all the restaurant displayed in the as integrated with the framework. After getting the restaurant details, we click on then all the required data from the JSON we get from there.
This was the phase 2 version of our application, the beta version of our application. We have changed the layout completely in our phase 3 application.
Our whole application has been converted in a very
It is just to integration with the Django framework we are testing.
No UI was improved in this. In the phase 3, we have improved a lot in the UI application. In the phase 3, we have fixed the...
Yes, a dumb question. So are you also kind of retrieving, I saw in your SRS, I don't know what to say, but are you retrieving the weather details of wherever? I know it's 5 kilometers, all the same weather.
Yeah, yes, sir.
Have you tried something on those lines?
Sorry, sir.
Like retrieving the weather, say for example, if you're going for
weather condition.
Weather.
No, sir, we are not.
We can implement.
We can implement that.
We can add it.
There is an API of Google as well for that weather also. So directly, we can show that to the salesman as well.
So if there is a
cloudy or
rainy,
1 kilometer, 5 kilometer, that
yeah, no, yeah. If the distance is large, it may affect. So in the phase three, in the phase two, we have integrated all the backend and front end. Just the UI was changed and some bugs which we have encountered in phase 2. So firstly, we have fixed the bugs in our Android application and modified some server code, improvising mobile UI and testing application and the REST API testing. Additional features which we have included are the Google Maps and the filters.
So for improvising the mobile UI, what are they? You're using a native or using something else for the UI part?
So the Android application, not native.
Okay, so what are you using?
Android Studio.
So it's native.
Yeah, it's a native, not hybrid.
So, whatever you're using is Android Studio.
Yeah.
No, no, it's a third party API.
No, no.
So as we have shown, the previous application was of no UI. So this has the change which we have created. This is the login page of our application, the registration page. After logging to the application, first of all, it will be asked for GPS location permission. After setting, this is the screenshot which you can filter within your application. If you want to change, by default it is 5 kilometers, you can change it to 0 to 10. If 0, you will be shown that no restaurants is displayed, and up to the radius. After selecting the distance, you will be getting the restaurants which have the business requirements, and these all are the tags which are clickable. And after clicking on the restaurant name, like which we have the Zomato and Swiggy apps, after clicking on the restaurant, they go inside the application of the page. So these are the latitude and longitude which were shown as the toast in the application. So
when you click on get directly, it goes within
your
app.
It will go directly to the Google Maps and show you the direction.
We have shown it.
And if you click on the card, it will show you the business requirement which they have given to us.
So if you click on the card, this will be the business requirement which the restaurant has. Like we have added a demo business requirement, and you can add a meeting and view a meeting which for the previous business requirement this restaurant has been confirmed. And if you click on the get direction, it will directly switch to Google Maps, and from the current location it will be selecting the latitude and longitude of the restaurant. Like if I click on the Harper and Holly's get direction, so it will directly get the latitude longitude and give you the direction to reach the restaurant. And if you want to add any meeting, this is the form. These three fields are read only forms. Employee ID, restaurant ID, and business employee opportunity ID is read only. These only entries are available to the salesperson to enter. After adding the meeting record, a meeting data will be generated in the form of card. So this was the demo meeting record which we added. So if the person wants to check which meeting he has conducted, so this was the meeting which just now we have generated. So for the Uber and Holly restaurant, so in the My Meetings tab in our navigation bar, so if he will click on My Meeting, he will get the meeting which he has conducted in any previous restaurant. And to the profile, he can see his profile, and he can also change the password.
So this My Meeting, so whenever the user creates a record,
Dynamically it gets a new card, and it's and it can get
for this record. Meeting, all the salesperson who has done meeting for that business requirement will be shown over here. And for this My Meeting, for which that particular salesman has shown, that meetings only will be shown.
This meeting, the screen that was here, this meeting is of view meetings, which the restaurant has of
all
any employees, any salesperson.
That's from the restaurant point of view.
Yeah, for restaurant point of view. But if the salesperson want to see his meetings, then he can click here and he can get his meetings only by his employer.
And you make rest calls for the instruction.
Yes.
And what if there's a server disconnection? How do you manage? Have you considered that? Say for example, I'm a agent and I'm making a record entry.
Yeah.
And suddenly, I mean, there's no network connect. Wherever I'm going to a particular restaurant or wherever, there's no network available. So, have you thought?
At the time,
but you're not storing anything on the local device, local cache.
No.
We are means using sessions.
So it has to come in.
So for the change, we added also the feature of change password if the salesperson wants to change password. So this will be the layout of the change password, and after that, if you want clicks on to the logout, it will ask for do you want to log out. Yes.
The session will be closed.
So after we completing the app, we have done some test cases in a mock-up. We have done some one-by-one activity for registration, login, get location, display restaurant, add meeting, and application testing done on. These testing done on the online as a website called Mockup. It will test all the test cases of the screens one by one within an hour. And it will give the all the result of the screens, what is the condition of the skin, whether there is any error, an ANR or something.
But
so
mock-up, you use any simulator or how do you use
it? No, it's not. See, it's an APK we have to upload and then website will generate all the data from that.
Yeah,
but
the,
how do you test the UI of the...
It automatically tests all the direction to it, like it checks the performance of the internet, performance of the application, internet speed, any layout, it will check also the, it will, if the application
buttons
is responsive
or not,
buttons are clickable or not, any crash happens to the application while running,
we have,
all the features will be tested.
You pass a link to the application.
No, we just give the APK
upload
to
the
application. It will automatically test, the software will automatically test and it will generate a report.
If we are using, suppose there is flashing, if we are using more than 5 seconds flashing, then it will suggest us that the, you are using the some more than 5 seconds, so reduce that some time.
We have added
like
the report in our report, so if you want to look.
That is for the
REST API. Yeah, the
backend purpose. REST API we have checked on Postman. Page number
27.
22.
How do you manage the
different
screen sizes or screen
resolution? Sir, it's dynamic. It's
responsive.
Yeah. We make sure that after the phase 2, it was recommended that make those applications
responsive.
So we made those changes.
Yes, sir.
We
have selected the relative layout.
So the 6-inch phone or the 7-inch?
Yeah, it's a relative layout.
Some
errors of bugs, then what they say, mock-ups? It will highlight the result?
Yeah, it will highlight
the result.
There is a screenshot, there are no errors and exceptions.
Okay. We are gradually testing it and we have finally added the report of the
Patel.
Patel, yes, sir.
Siddharth?
So we have created a video,
small video also,
and we have also the demo. So we will take only 2 minutes for the video and 5 minutes for the demo. But this was the testing stage, like validation.
We check manually.
If the restaurant has no business requirement within the area, so it will say that we can't.
Suppose while registering, if you give space between the email, then it will not take. We have
all the validations
are
working.
Just show the video.
Yes.